What you're seeing here is the spacecraft that actually carried astronauts McDivitt and White on the first American walk in space. For the United States, it was essentially a catch-up situation. Before Gemini 4 was launched, the plan originally was for White to stand up in the seat and stick his body out of the spacecraft. But then the Soviets had the first walk in space on March 23, 1965, with Alexei Leonov. After Leonov went out, the space program officials and the astronauts, McDivitt and White, said, why don't we try to actually do a walk? The Soviets had done this. We had to demonstrate we could do it, too.
Lift off.
And that was really important in terms of symbolizing America being competitive with the Soviet Union in the space race.
We just had word from Houston. We're ready to have you get out whenever you're ready.
Okay, we've got our go now. Is that right?
Affirmative.
The spacewalk went really well when White was outside. He was ecstatic. It was just an enormous experience to be outside the spacecraft.
Okay, he's out. He's close to three.
Okay, I'm coming over.
It looks beautiful.
I feel like $1 million.
You have this full 360-degree view of the Earth below you and the universe above you. During the walk, White tested the handheld gas gun to see how it maneuvered. He floated around, and he didn't really want to stop.
This is the greatest experience. It's just tremendous. Right now, I'm standing on my head, and I'm looking right down. It looks like we're coming up on the coast of California.
And the ground control said, tell him to get back in.
The flight director says, get back in.
Back in?
Back in.
He said, jokingly, this is the saddest moment of my life. He had to cram all that umbilical back in the seat and get himself wedged down. Once you start to do real work in space, then you fight against your inflated spacesuit. And if you don't have a good cooling system, and the Gemini spacesuit didn't, you become enormously overheated. That only happened to White during the very last part when he was trying to wedge himself in the seat and ratchet the hatch handle down. But in general, we drew the lesson that it wasn't hard to spacewalk. And that was kind of misleading, as it turned out later on.